Oh, I just wanna take you anywhere that you like. We could go out any day, any night. Baby, I'll take you there, take you there. Hi everybody, I'm Allison Gonzalez, and I know it's a little loud in my house because it's Super Bowl party today. But here, I'm not here bringing you Super Bowl, I'm bringing you Valentine's Day. So I made some stuff that are really cool and anybody can make them using two of my favorite things. The first one is this rainbow loom kind of thing in a specific kind of pattern. And this card, which I think is gorgeous, that I made with some household. And it's all these things are very inexpensive. So I'm going to show you guys how to do both of them. And at the end, there's a little giveaway that I'm giving you guys. So watch out for that giveaway. So let's get started with the rainbow loom. Okay, so first we're going to be working with our rainbow loom gift. Here's my rainbow loom box that I bought in Michael's for $15, I believe. And you can hold all your different kinds of looms and the actual colors. So the colors that we're going to be using today are this kind of light pink. If you put it in the sun, it's very beautiful. This purple and this red and some white. So now that we have all of our colors, you're just going to take a little bit of each one because we're just going to do one strip, and you can use whichever one. I'm going to use the middle one because I like the middle one. And first, you're just going to take your first band, which is our red one. You're going to move it from one little peg to the next one, just like that, so that all the colors don't look very mushed up. And you're going to get it from the second peg to the third peg. And you're going to keep on doing that with the different patterns. So after red, we're going to do white, like I just did. Then after white, we're going to do pink. They got stuck together. We're going to do pink. Then once again, after pink, we're going to put white. So after every main color, we're going to put white so it stands out. And after purple, we are going to put white. And you're going to continue this all the way to the end. Okay, so now that we filled it all the way to the end, we're going to take our little rainbow loom tool and we're going to flip this loom so that the red arrow is pointing to us. So you're going to take your tool and you're going to pull this purple band across and let it meet the other band. That's pretty simple. Then you're going to take this white one under the purple, pick it up. It's easy to go by side to side so it doesn't fall off. And go like that, kind of in a circular shape, circular motion. And you're going to do this all the way to the end. Okay, so now that I've done it all the way to the end, we are going to take a C-clip, which looks something like this. Very tiny and see-through, and whenever you buy any of the bags for the bands, you're gonna find them. So we're just gonna take our C-clip and put it right in the middle for this big band, which is our white. We're just gonna pull it off and be careful with the last one because that could fall off. And you are just going to attach it to your tool and make sure to put it all the way in the back. We're going to use this later on. Okay, since this is too small to put on your arm, if you have a small arm then you can do it, we are going to do the entire step once again. Okay, so now that we filled it all the way to the top, you're going to take the rest of your loom that you first started with off of your tool, and you're just going to add it right there. It's okay that the two reds are connecting. That looks fine. It's just the separation between the patterns. That's okay. So now we are, since I already flipped it, having the red pointing me, we are going to pull from this part. We're going to pull the original loom back and you'll see this red band. You're going to do the exact same thing that you did with the other part. With this white, I'm going to put it to this white, and this purple,
gonna pick up. And remember to do a circular motion, guys. Oh, if it falls, it's okay. Just pick it back up and it'll be fine. Yeah. Okay, so now that we're done, I'm just gonna pull this off once again. Remember, be careful with the last one. Oh, it fell off, but it's okay. And use the next one, which is my pink one. And you're just going to connect it there. Just put it on top of the little holes. And with your nails, that was my parents. I'm so sorry, they're watching the football game. And with your nail, you're gonna push it in. And you have your Valentine's Day band. For our next project, we need construction paper, glitter, some stickers from Michaels, and different color Sharpies. Okay, so now get out your three construction papers and your scissors. Oh, sorry about that. Don't want to cut myself. And now we take our red construction paper and fold it in half. And make sure to slide down the creases so it does not get messed up. Now take your pencil and just draw out an outline of the heart. So when you cut it, it can be exact. Now you can't see it very well now because I drew it very lightly, but I did do it. Sorry about that. So now you're just going to cut as slow as possible. I like to do it fast, but it's better to do it slow so you get all those details and the right thing. So when you're done, it's a gorgeous heart. Oh, how cute. So adorable. And you can save the outside for another day. You can use it at any time, but mine is kind of broken, so I won't use it. So now, we're going to do the exact same thing with our purple. Okay, so now that I've folded the blue paper, it's purple. So we're going to take our red heart and just draw another outline so we know exactly how big the red one is so we can make the purple one smaller. So I drew it very lightly once again. And now, I'm going to draw a second heart in the middle, as you can see. And I kind of messed up, so I'm just erasing it a little bit. And making it a little bit more pointy. And it's okay if it comes out bad. All the stuff that we're gonna add on top of it will make it beautiful. So now, once again, you're gonna follow the same procedures and you're gonna cut it out. And look how cute that purple is. Kind of lopsided, but it's okay. Now that we've cut out our purple, we are going to take our white construction paper or any kind of paper, doesn't really matter, and fold that once again. And we're gonna take our purple, like we did with our red, and outline it. Since this is the white, you will be able to see it a lot better. And, oops, sorry about that. And we're gonna draw once again another one in the middle. And like always, we are going to cut the heart out. And if you want to recycle anymore, you can recycle the paper to add any other snowflakes for other decorations, maybe for your room or something. That'll be nice. And that's how the heart looks when it's done. So just to see how it looks, we're just putting it on top and it looks beautiful. So now on to the decorating. Now we're gonna take some glue and first put it on the back of the purple so that we can stick it on the red. I'm using Elmer's glue. It's a little bit dry, but it will hold on, don't worry. You can use any type of glue, whatever is your favorite. Doesn't really matter, as long as it sticks. So now we're gonna put it on to the red and kind of squish it a little bit so it actually stays on. We don't want it falling off. Now you're gonna do the same procedure to the white heart. You're gonna flip it over to the side, whichever maybe you did drawings on, to sketch it out, you just put glue on that side. So since this paper was a little bit flimsy, it kind of folded on me, but it's okay. So now we're gonna stick that on, and once again, like the purple, we're gonna squish it so it stays. So now we're gonna take our Sharpies with my red Sharpie. Just gonna make a little outward border. And with my blue Sharpie, I'm gonna make a purple border around the purple heart so that it kind of pops out. You don't have to do this procedure, but it makes it look beautiful. So when you're done with that procedure, you're gonna take your pearl letters from Michaels that are only about $5. Just going to open them up and take them out and spell the word Happy Valentine's Day. And when you're peeling them off, be careful because I learned that some of the jewels fall off when you're peeling them off. I was not very happy when that happened. But, you know, I never knew. I didn't read the back of the instructions. I'm not really that kind of girl when I really should. Anyway, so you're just going to take your H and try to put it on the corner so that it doesn't get too squished up. Just make sure to pat it down so it stays in. So now I finished putting the letters and put some jewels on the side. Now, since Valentine's didn't fit, since it's a big word, I just put Valentine's, but don't worry, people will get it. It's just an abbreviation. So, as you can see, it kind of slipped over the actual white border. That's because, once again, it is a very big word. So, I decided to put some jewels on the side, the ones in the other packet, pink and purple. Now, we're just going to take our glitter, and I just like dumping them out of the floor. Very messy I am. So you just take whichever colors you want. I took like some pinks and some reds and some purples. And we are going to use that within the rest of the part to put on the heart in the middle of some of the jewels. So now I'm just going to take the color red and put it in between the red hearts. So just squeeze it very lightly. And if it takes, it's the first time, it's usually a little bit hard, but then the actual tube gets used to it being squeezed a lot. Oh, sorry about that. And you're just going to want to put it in the middle of everything. If you guys want to know where I got this, I got it at Michael's for a very inexpensive price. And I love doing these kinds of arts and crafts stuff. So if you guys want more, just comment below and tell me if you guys want me to do anything else, because, you know, I love doing these kinds of things for you guys. And plus, I have all these household materials, so it's so fun and easy to do. Oh, and if a big blob comes out, don't worry, just smush it out. Okay, so now that I fixed those big blobs, I'm going to take the white glitter, which has very little for mine, so I'm just going to try to squeeze it. And if you don't want to, since it's very overpowering, you don't have to do these glitter things. You can just do the Valentine's Day hearts and forget about the jewels. It's okay. Doesn't really matter. As long as you do it with all your heart, anybody that you give this to will love it. So when it's completed, it looks something like this. I can't help but smile at it, guys. This is so beautiful. And I hope you guys enjoyed making these things as much as I did. Okay guys, thank you for watching this video. So here's the giveaway that you guys all been waiting for. A $10 iTunes gift card. And the only thing that you have to do to win this thing is to first like and subscribe to this video. Then comment below which was your favorite, either the card or the bracelet. And if you have an Instagram account or a Twitter, post a picture of any of these things that you made under the hashtag Allison Gonzalez Valentines, and you might have a chance to win. And you can comment and post things on Instagram more than once, so you have a more likely chance to win this awesome gift card. Thank you guys so much. Have a great day. Bye. Here's the giveaway that I'm gonna give you guys. Take it, cut it, press the same button.
Hold on, you're smart. This is all going to loopers, right?
This is all going to... You're still recording? Mm-hmm. Smart one, take it off! You know what we should do, though? No, this is like a blooper, you know? Like one of those bloopers.
Just go.
Okay, take it out.
How do I turn it off?
Turn it on with the button. Like, you see the button right there?
This one?
That one. Push it.